coming to you, and we invite you to come into one of our services to bring glory and honor to God's name, to raise up a supernatural army with signs and wonders and miracles. Can you be part of this move? In Jesus' name, and everybody say amen.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
One thing I will not do is back up and let up off of you if I see that you can grow and I can grow. I'll come to you and say, we're lacking here in this area. Some say amen.
Okay.
Amen. We're lacking. We need to grow here in this area. Brother Dave's up here trying to shove all this kind of stuff. Brother Michael, you're going to have more stuff to talk about. He impressed Brother Cook so much. Brother
yes,
Cook
he did.
Said amen.
Yes, he did impress.
Brother Cook didn't even hear anything, but knew through the Spirit of God the calling. Come on, talk to me here. And you think that devil ain't got to work on him? How many of you know the devil's going to work on you? Did you know my armor bearer is going to work on you? My world mission woman is going to work on you? Come on, talk to me. All of you. And if we don't stick together, honey, it's over. And the enemy knows that. Infiltrate and divide. Get in there with them, and then divide them up. Remember the story about Jesus in the temple? The Bible says, and there was a man in the temple that had a devil. How long have been in the temple? We don't know. But when Jesus came in, the Bible says, he cried out, let us alone! We know who you are, the most holy Son of God. See, he could sit there and cause a little kind of trouble when the Spirit of God, the anointing, came in. You know, he had to act up. And we see a lot of activity of devils in our lives and in the ministry. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And we can't just say, well, you need to pity him. Pity him what? If they want to be set free, we'll pray and they can be set free. But if they don't want it, how many of you know you can't cast a devil out of a person that wants the devil out of them?
That's right.
Some people have a rebellious spirit and they will want to keep that rebellious spirit. How many of you heard me say many, many times over that I'm looking forward to the day that I could do exactly what I did this evening here? Coming late, don't hear nothing going on, y'all have everything going. I come in, deliver the message, grab a satchel and sneak out. Then you all have to take, lay it on the hands and pray and pray. I'm in and out. You don't need me here for all that stuff. You all have the same gifts.
That's right.
To me, somebody.
Amen. That's right.
Well, I'm not a prophet. No, but you have the gift of prophecy. Anybody here?
Amen.
So if the devil's been working on you, trying to get you off to the side or whatever, that's a good sign. How many of you believe that Brother Humphrey has done the very best he knows how to encourage every last one of you?
Yes.
Amen.
No pat my back or anything. But you've never seen me ever go to anybody and try to put somebody down. I'm always trying to pick you up, lift you up, encourage you. See, God wants to use you. Here's a position. Let's go now. Come on, take it. Can you imagine if we just closed doors, if I'd been a thick head? What would happen to Pakistan? What happened to our television ministry here? What happened to you guys preaching and teaching? Come on, what happened? Come on, talk to me somebody.
That's right.
What happened to the loved ones and stuff that God's bringing yours in now and doing things with? So say amen.
Amen.
Brandon
and Brittany, they got saved
here. Say what, brother?
Brandon and Brittany, they got saved here.
I just can't hear it through my ear.
Talking about Brandon and Brittany, they got saved here.
Exactly. I said to Brandon last evening, he said, I'll just tell you this conversation. He said, Brother Humphrey, he said, I don't want to go no more. He said, I feel so good when I talk to you one-to-one. He said, I'm lifted up. But he said, as soon as I get in there, he said, I feel the rejection against me.
Oh, Jesus.
I said, you got to be there tomorrow night. He said, I'll be there. Is he? People would press on him and demanded to get married. Pastor Cook said, marry him. Guess what? I will not marry him, and I will not even go to their marriage. I told him this. I'll not marry you. I won't go to your marriage. You know why I won't? Because I'm not going to have a devil say, we forced him into doing what we wanted to.
Right.
See, the devil loves to manipulate you, to control you, and make you do what he wants you or she wants you to do. Just talk to me, somebody.
Amen.
Then if they get an inch,
take it on.
They'll come back again. They're going to get married. Where? I don't know. They already set their date, but he's going to change it. I told him, I said, no, I'm not. I will not marry you. I won't come to your marriage. There's a great potential that people says that they were shacking up. My God, to be together for 11 years, two little kids. God baptized them with the Holy Ghost and all this and that. And I made the statement to the individual that said, are they saved? I said, are they saved? Are they saved? They wouldn't answer me. Mm-hmm. How many of you know that is a spirit of enemy? I don't know everything. How many of you here know everything?
Yeah.
How many of you love to be forced into things?
Nope.
That's what happened to me and my wife when we first got saved. Went to church, such and such a church. Man, I'm telling you one thing. My wife's going to hell many different ways. Her hair wasn't right, her sleeves wasn't right, and this wasn't right, and that wasn't right. My kids were going to hell because they wore over two shoes, and all kinds of stuff. And we're not couple our hands back, blessings, all kinds of junk.
Religious spirits.
That's exactly what it is. Sister, that's exactly what God spoke to me today. God said a religious, self-righteous spirit. A religious, self-righteous spirit. See, the devil likes to be religious and self-righteous. You better listen to me. How many know we have to reveal? We don't have to go to name names and all this and that. But we can talk about that spirit. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I cried so much about situations. That I weakened myself so much that my immune system became down so bad. Mm-hmm. Crying out to God because of situations and individuals. And finally God spoke to me three times harshly. Let it alone. Oh. I said let it alone. I said let it alone. Do you know Jeremiah wept so much for the people of Israel and so forth, and everybody turned against him? And then finally God spoke and said, do not pray for me any longer, because I'll not hear your prayers. I don't ever want to get there. And I sure as God don't want to see anybody else get there. What can we do? We can pray for them, but after a while God said, don't pray, it's done. God's going to have a people that's going to be one mind and one accord. Somebody say amen. Yeah. Peter's son set free indeed, but that don't mean that we're free to do what we want to do in the flesh.
Right.
Did anybody still hear
amen.
Me?
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank God for his grace, his mercy, and the Spirit of God. He says, for occasion of flesh, but by love serve one another. How many of you know we're supposed to serve one another? We should be more conscious, more willing to go our way for somebody else than even for ourselves.
Yes. Right.
For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. Verse 15, but if you bite and devour one another. How many know what that is? Bite and devour one another.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, did you know that they actually run up on Stephen and actually bit him?
Wow.
Before they stoned him to death? They bit him. How many of you ever had someone bite you? I've had it a couple times. When I was just a little boy, my little niece, this other girl, this Is that a girl or is that a boy? Niece?
Girl.
She's a little panther. We was fighting in a little wagon. And she attacked me like a panther and got me by the nipple.
Oh.
And almost broke my nipple, still got scars in the Then I was in the army and I was fighting an Indian boy from North Dakota. He was like a lion. He bit me up like a stinking lion. Come on.
Wow.
I don't like to be bit at the same time. But if you bite and devour one another, how many devour? Devour means eat them up. Destroy them. You bite them so much, you just chew them up and eat them up. Destroy them. But if you bite and devour one another, take heed that you be not consumed one of another. In other words, if you do it to somebody else, it's going to come back to you. I mean, now you start trouble in somebody's life or a ministry or whatever, it's going to come back.
Right.
It might only be a matter of time. I can tell you story after story.
Right.
Where people came and done thus and thus, I won't go into all that stuff. And God said, it's only a matter of time. I watched the same individual start a big church, grew like everything. My mother and sister went, and I'm telling you what, it looked like, man, I was way off base. And God speaks to me year after year, it's only a matter of time. And following that man, fell in sin with his secretary, was taking money, his kids went on drugs, his wife left him in divorce, and yet to this day he's totally backslided. My wife can tell you, you talk to him, you have better talk than chance to talk to that stone wall than talk to him. You know why? The seed you sow, the seed you reap. This I say then, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. I mean, that's what I've been trying to teach you on all these months. Walk in the Spirit. Be led in the Spirit. Somebody say amen.
Yeah.
The Spirit will check us and say, don't say that. Don't do that. But how many know we can quench and grieve the Spirit by going ahead and do what we want to do? Verse 17, for the flesh lusts against the Spirit, and the Spirit against the flesh. And these are contrary. Here's the flesh and the Spirit of God. Back and forth. The one is contrary to the other. So that you cannot do the thing that you should. See, if the Spirit of God is not controlling our life, we're not going to do what God wants us to do. It's just that simple. I cannot believe that people can look at this Word of God and see how simple it is and still not understand it. It amazes me. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Verse 8, but if you be led by the Spirit, you're not under the law. How many of you know this is good. How many of you know, thou shalt not steal, and thou shalt not commit adultery, and all this. That's commandments, that's law. So that's works of the flesh. But if you're in the Spirit of God, you don't have any trouble with that.
Right.
Sister Rachel, you have any trouble with committing adultery?
Yes.
Come on, talk to me here. Come on. I mean, if you're for Him, you don't do it because you don't want to do it because you're in love with Him.
Right.
But if you're not in the Spirit, you're in the flesh, so you can't love Him. So these are all works. Somebody say amen. Years ago, I took and did a study, an in-depth study on what these words are. The first one, it says adultery. How many of you know what adultery is? Sexual intercourse between a married person with somebody else. So that's adultery. Fornication means sexual intercourse between unmarried people. When it says uncleanliness, is indecency and dirty-minded. How many of you know, we don't need to get around people that say indecent and dirty-minded.
Right.
Do you know there's a lot of dirty-minded people that say they're Christian? You could say the simplest little thing,
yeah.
And they'll take it dirty-minded.
Yeah.
I was preaching years ago, and my wife says, my kid says it too, and I said, and God would have us to have good success. And they said, I said, God will have us all to have good sex.
Yes.
People got all worked up because even if I did say that, it should have been no big dirty deal. So to say amen. Now, if this offends you, then you got trouble with your flesh. If I say a married couple should enjoy their sex, God made it pleasant. So to say amen.
That's right.
He made it so we'd be intimate with one another. He did not make it cruddy.
Right.
Somebody say amen.
That's right. Amen.
So a lot of times we're just so indecent-minded, dirty-minded, quick to take things out of order. He says, lasciviousness means lustfulness. How many know people are lustful? They want everything you got. Everybody now, we all should, all the women should dye their hair like Sister Annabelle now. That's pretty hair. And no, we should do it like Sister Jen, because Sister Jen comes and said she colored hers. Well, no, wait. Maybe we ought to do it like Sister Rachel. She's got a highlighter streaks. But no, we all should do it like Sister So. She don't put nothing on it. Come on. That's a beautiful tie you got there, Brother Dave. I wouldn't mind having that myself. Brother Michael, you know my favorite color is blue, and you're just dressed in blue. And if you really love Jesus, you give that to me. Idolatry. Worshiper of idols. How many know a lot of people, that does not mean a carved idol or like Buddha, but how many know a lot of people have idols in their home, in their life? Idols are this. Anything that takes the place of God.
Right.
Do you know your job can become your idol?
Yes.
Do you know families has idols in their marriage? Their husband, the wife,
right.
The cat, the rat, the dog.
Yeah.
Come on, whatever.
Yeah.
Come on, talk to me here.
Rat.
We can set up an idol and don't even know we have an idol.
Right.
I'll never forget we had certain people. Came to our church years ago. They was wealthy. And they all loved to outclass one another. And one had this brand new, I don't know, it was Cadillac or Lincoln. They was always getting, every year, the biggest and the best whatever came out. And right there close to the church, they had a car wash. And I was going by the car wash, and this woman was out on top, outside, down, looking across the roof, and then she'd go,
Oh, Lord, have mercy. Wow.
My wife gets mad at me because I don't wash my vehicles, and I should wash it. But I did not get it to wash it.
I didn't get that
at all. What did you call it, a screwball?
A crud ball. I said, I don't want to say that.
Crud ball, okay. But how many of you know it's... I got to go to my job. I just talked to a guy this week who said, I can't come to church because my boss said I have to work. Do you know what his God is? His idol is? His job.
Yeah.
I said, no, your boss says you're supposed to be in church. My boss said, I'm not supposed to be. I said, do what you want to do, buddy. He said, have no other gods before me. No other gods before me.
Right.
Witchcraft, power and practice of sorcery. You know there's a lot of people that still read, they say their curses, read their horoscope.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Read your fortune cookie. Come on. Or search these things online. Is there, how do you know?
Yep.
God told me, I told you this before, but you're trying to go on real quick here. God told me many years ago, how many remember Star Trek?
Mm-hmm.
I love that program. And MASH. How many of you ever watched MASH? That was my two programs. And I was watching Star Trek, and God said, stop dabbling with witchcraft.
Yeah.
I went, what? Stop dabbling with witchcraft. I was in shock. And then all of a sudden he brought before my mind Spock and all that kind of stuff, you know. And I stopped watching it. Yet this day, I flushed this channel and I had to flush real quick. But then I still had MASH on. And my wife, she ruined that for me. Remember, what's her name?
Hot Lips
Houlihan. And they're all doing things. And my wife, she started saying, you're watching Horror Story again.
Yeah.
But she's cheating on her husband.
She ruined it for me. Do you know it's to a point now that I'm sick of washing anything?
Amen. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You don't know what to watch.
Ain't nothing worth watching.
It ain't. Seriously, honest to God, it's not.
Gunsmoke.
Gunsmoke is still killing me, you know.
Yeah. At least they're old time.
But seriously.
Well, watch the weather. Maybe.
Honestly, I'm telling you what, the closer we get to Him, the further away that stuff will get away from us.
Amen.
Isn't that true?
Yes.
When He said, behold, all things will pass away, behold, all things become new, He meant everything.
Yeah. We had that verse this morning.
Did you really? Amen. Hallelujah. That's confirmation. When He says all things, He means everything.
Yeah.
So say amen. Everything. Mm-hmm. Everything in life. Every last thing you could think of. Mm-hmm. What used to mean a lot to you.
Yeah.
I mean, we built a monster of a house. And I, you know, we're going to take something big, monstrous place. And I was sort of like, now I look at it and I said, my God, if I could just have a little house trailer. Go back to what we
started with.
I mean, it loses glitter.
Yeah.
He changes everything in our life. Oh, God. Hallelujah. How many of you can say, we're going to keep on going?
Amen.
Come on. By the grace of God, we're not giving up.
I know.
We are not.
God says we're
going to make it.
Amen.
She just said that thing. Going to get me crying again. I was so worked up yesterday and so forth, when I did finally get up, I kind of lay in that bed anymore because I had pain and anything and everything. I was sitting there watching the deer. I hit the radio. Guess what song called? Come on. God said you're going to make it. God said you're going to make it. Oh, then I went to bed. How many of you, when you're laying in bed, songs come in your mind?
Yes. Mm-hmm. You can't get it.
And you hear that song, you sing a song, and now it goes into tongues, and now you're singing in tongues. And guess what song I was singing?
God
said, come on. Yes. I hear that song for him. He's still working on him and making where he ought to be. Come on. Hallelujah. Let's close here. Witchcraft. Power and practice of sorcery. My God. How many of you know we have really had our share of witches?
Yeah.
I mean witches. I mean full-fledged, down-home witches. Then he says hatred. What's hatred? Strong dislike or ill will?
Right.
Strong dislike. I love you like the devil loves you. Hatred. What did you do? How many of they hated Jesus? What did he do? He done good. Come on, we don't have to go any further on that. Variance, not in harmony. That's what works of the flesh. Not in harmony. Brother Dave, tell me what happens to a car or to an engine if all the spark plugs are not working together?
It's not gonna run.
It misfires.
It misfires. And you go down there, chick, and smoke flying. Come on. Not hard. How many of they all got? That's why we have a thing called a timing.
Yeah.
Timing chain, timing belt. To keep them all timed together.
Of course, they're going to jail for that.
Emulation, overambition. Overambition. That was your husband here the other night?
Yes, and just so you know, he told me what you told him. Wasn't going to get in that line until you sat and talked to him. And I was back there letting everybody go before me because I was holding the spot for him. And he said, Brother Humphrey told me this, and you told him he was a mighty man of God. And he said, he's wrong. And I said, no, he's not. And I said, he's telling you what's to come. I said, Yahweh and the word God. I said, you are a mighty man of God. I said, it just has to be.
See, I don't remember what all God spoke to me, but one thing God spoke to me before we ever met, God spoke and said, first thing the Lord said, you cannot put the cart before the horse.
Right.
You can't, or but God's got a divine calling on you,
right.
But you're too zealous, too ambitious to go. You need training.
Yes.
You need to slow down and let God do the work in you and through you before you can teach and preach others.
And Brother Cook told him that he needs to learn the word. He's been reading. He has been reading, praise the Lord. But Brother Cook did tell him he needs to learn the word of God.
See, what's God doing? Confirming it.
Yes.
So we say, man. So some people, you know, once you get out and do this, so Bob said, a novice, a beginner's not allowed to preach or teach. Where are we at?
Wrath,
violent anger, rage, strife, fights after conflict and decision, people just, anything, sedition, law against lawful authority, heresy, a religious opinion contrary to the word of God, envying, jealousy, brooding desire to have something that don't belong to you, murders, you know what that is, drunkenness, and violence, to use vile language. But how many of you know that I believe that God chose the pillars tonight to be here? I really, when I look around at you, I look at pillars. So we say amen. But also when I look at the others comes in, I can see them future pillars. One woman said to me the other night, she said, is there a tape that you'd recommend for me? I said, yes it is. And that quick, the tape came to mind, the great potential. And she went back and she had two of them. Another woman came up here and sat down beside me. She wanted to know what was about the baptism of the Holy Ghost. What is it? And I explained to her and it made sense. She said, I'm coming back. I said, when you come back, I said, the right timing. I said, you'll receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. How many of you know God's working? Come on, talk to me.
Yes.
So there's great potential for God to, and anybody come, just try to let them know that Brother Humphrey don't force things on you, but he will encourage you and do everything he can for you to step out of the position where you're at and to hire from glory to glory. So say amen. So say amen.
For Upper Room Ministry. You can see the rest of this message each Sunday evening, your local time. If you would like to receive our monthly newsletter and know the things the Lord is speaking to Prophet Humphrey, then please send a love offering to help cover our expenses. Also, if you would like to have an anointed prayer cloth and become a ministry partner, send us your picture so we can pray, lay hands on you and your need, and expect signs, wonders, and miracles in your life. Starting today, you will never be the same. Our website is upperroomministry.net. If you would like to schedule a speaking engagement, contact our ministry. All glory to Jesus. Amen. Amen.